Okay, we're going to try to take a hardness test on this file. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go to the dial and we're going to turn the bezel, that's the outer ring, until the B and the C line up. And it doesn't matter if the B and the C are straight up and down, it's just the dial moves to the indicator. So we're just going to line those up. You always have to do that in the first step. Now our part's already on the large flat platen. This is our file. And we've ground out an area in the middle of the file so we can get right down to the base metal to get the hardness test. Something with files is they always have these ridges in them. Those are the cutting edges. You don't want to take a hardness test on those because you'll get a false reading. So we're going to put that down. We're going to basically place it underneath our diamond conical point indenter. That's what we have in the collar. And we're going to turn the hand wheel on the nut clockwise, and that's going to raise the table up. That'll take quite a few turns, and you can do it fairly quickly at the beginning, but as you reach the indenter, you want to move a little bit slower because you don't want to smash the table and the part into the indenter because you can break the industrial diamond. So I'm coming up here. I want to make sure the part is aligned underneath the indenter. Notice that the dial has not moved because I'm not in contact with the indenter just yet. Now I'm coming in contact right now, so I'm going to move a little bit slow. And what you'll notice here, this smaller indicator right here, that's our preload indicator. And what we're going to do is we're going to load up the indenter. So we're going to push it down into the part. Actually, we're going to raise the part into the indenter, but we're going to push it down. We're going to try to push that diamond point into the part, and that's going to give us our preload. And that's a fairly small load. And what we're going to do is we're going to put enough lift on the upright screw in order to turn the small knob three times. And it doesn't take very much. And the indicator dial will move while we're doing this. So what I'm doing is I'm just turning very slowly the hand wheel. You can see that small dial's moving. I just went around once, just went around twice, and I'm reaching the red dot there, and I want to bring this up, you know, as close as I can get it to the B and the C. I kind of went by there a little bit. That's okay. That's my preload. I'm just going to readjust my dial now so that those are lined up. Now, that is not a hardness reading at that point. That is just the preload. So that diamond indenter is actually pushed down to a small degree into my workpiece. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to release the major load, and that's done through this knob right over here on this side. And it says to load over here, it says pull it forward, and I'm going to do that. And when I do that, you'll see that the dial begins to move up here. And what's happening in the back of the unit, we've got some weights back there and they're falling, and through a lever system, that's putting the major load on, and that's 150 kilograms for a Rockwell C test. That's set back here with this knob. That puts the major load on it. I can adjust that. That determines which weights are falling in the back. And when that knob has come all the way forward, right here, that's my reset knob. And when that's all the way forward and the dial stops moving, that means the major load has been applied. So now I need to release the major load so I can take the reading on the dial for the hardness. This right now is not the hardness. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to push this lever back. And what that's going to do is that's going to pull the weights back up so that I've taken off the major load. And now my hardness I can read directly from the dial. The Rockwell C number right here is this outside black set of indicators right here. And that's pointing at about, that looks about 50, oh, maybe 56, 57 Rockwell C. So that file is about 57 to 58 Rockwell C, and that's about the right number for a file. So to release the part, the diamond indicator is still in contact with that part right now. I need to turn the hand wheel counterclockwise. Okay, so I'm gonna actually like loosen it. So remember, you know, righty tighty, lefty loosey here. To bring it up into the part, I turn it clockwise. To release the part, to move the table down, I'm gonna turn this counterclockwise, and that releases the part. And my hardness test is complete, and you can see all the indentations in this file from the various hardness tests that we have taken. So that's basically how we hardness test a workpiece on our Rockwell C hardness tester.